Hello there. Glassfish 3.1.2 is getting released in the next few hours, and I'm here with the man responsible for the release. Satyan, please introduce yourself.
Hi, Arun. Good to be here. I'm the engineering manager for Glassfish 3.1.2. I am one of the development managers at Oracle, and I also recently managed Glassfish 3.1.1.
Excellent. So, with Glassfish 3.1.2, what are the key themes of this release?
So just to set the context for our discussion, we released Glassfish 3.1 in February of last year, 2011. Glassfish 3.1 was the first release to support Java E6 with clustering support, clustering storage. And we followed up 3.1 with 3.1.1 late last summer, July 2011. So that said, the theme of 3.1.2 or the main goals for 3.1.2 were to improve the quality of both 3.1 and 3.1.1 by making quality bug fixes and add many features on top of 3.1.1 and extend the software support we provide in terms of platforms, operating systems, and browsers.
Lovely. So let's double click on each of these themes and see what we have in them. So tell me about what did you do to improve the quality of the overall release?
So in 3.1.2, we have made over 500 bug fixes. These are high quality bug fixes. These bug fixes, some of them are identified by our community, and some of them came through customer requests, and some of the bugs were left over from the previous releases. So I'm proud to say that we have fixed over 500 bug fixes in this release. And on top of that, we have also made sure that by doing this bug fix, we are not introducing any new regressions, or we are not compromising on compatibility or performance of the product.
Beautiful. So that means anybody who is using 3.1.1 can just jump onto 3.1.2 and get all these bug fixes.
Correct.
Lovely. So, okay, tell me about the new features that are coming in 3.1.2 now.
As I said earlier, 3.1.2 is not just a bug fix release. It's also a release that had many features. I can talk about a few of them. The first one was the admin console parity with the CLI. When we released 3.1.1, there were about close to 25 plus CLI commands that were not exposed through console. So in 3.1.2, we made sure that all of those commands are available as an option in our admin console itself. And one of the feedback that we got from last year's Oracle Open World is the slowness of admin console during startup on certain platforms. So we make sure that we address that concern from the community, and we have improved the startup time by 70% in 3.1.2.
Fantastic. So that means our web-based administration console starts up 70% faster, right, and it has all those commands that were only in CLI so far.
Exactly.
Okay. More? What more features?
Those are the only two.
For
admin console, right?
Right.
Okay. So
tell us about the DCOM support.
Okay. So in 3.1.1, our remote management of instances were done through SSH. SSH is a secure shell protocol. And as you might know, configuring SSH is a nightmare on Windows because SSH is not native to Windows. So what we did in 3.1.2 is we have added support for DCOM, which is a distributed component management software technology from Microsoft, which is closely tied up to the operating system, so it doesn't require any configuration to be done by the user. So we've added support for DCOM for the remote instances to communicate in 3.1.2. And I should say this is in addition to our SSH support. So for people coming from 3.1 and 3.1.1, they will not be losing SSH support, but DCOM support will be available to them on Windows.
So customers starting brand new on Windows are recommended to use the DCOM-based provisioning and clustering and all those support very well.
Right.
Excellent. Tell us about the Eclipse Link support then.
So as you know, Glassfish provides the JP implementation through Eclipse Link. Eclipse Link is an open source project. And in addition to taking in all the JPA specific components from Eclipse Link and including it as part of Glassfish, in 3.1.2, we also have taken in Moxie component. Moxie is a JAXPY implementation, JAXPY as in binding. So we are giving more choice to Glassfish developers to use Eclipse Link Moxie as a JAXPY provider in addition to our Oracle's JAXPY implementation.
Nice, nice. That's very nice, actually. Yeah, I know Moxie has a good following actually outside in the Eclipse Link land.
Right.
So this will hopefully give one more option to our audience. So I hear something about Toppling Grid as well that is being included now.
Right. So in 3.1.1 and 3.1, we bundled Eclipse Link binaries for both our commercial branded GlassFish and also for community branded GlassFish. So in 3.12, what we are doing is we are bundling the commercial top link equivalent of Eclipse link in our commercial GlassFish server. And one of the library that we have added to the distribution is a top link grid, which is nothing but a jar file that through which the JP applications can access Coherence. And as you know, Coherence is a very powerful distributed cache management system that is also a product from Oracle.
Very nice, very nice. One of the complaints that we used to hear from the community is session failover capability in GlassFish is very nice, but it is restricted to multicast environment. Have we done anything to improve that?
Yes, in fact, starting from 3.12, we are supporting usage of GMS for environments where multicast is disabled. So we got this requirement from the field, and as you said, there were complaints about not enabling this on environments where multicast is disabled. So we have achieved that in 3.12.
Lovely. So that means, you know, in public clouds where multicast is not enabled, we could still have the benefits of session failover, clustering, all of those very seamlessly.
Right. You will have a complete clustering support in these environments also.
Very nice. Very nice. Tell me something about, you know, one thing GlassFish is very well known for is OSGI. So what version of OSGI, you know, are we using in 3.12 now?
So we moved to OSGI 4.3. This is just the core part of it. And obviously we take the Apache Felix implementation, which is based on 4.3. So we took the recent version of Apache Felix, which supports 4.3, and integrated it as part of GlassFish 3.12.
Excellent. What about, there is some transaction recovery feature updates that we have done as well?
Right. Recovering transactions, as you know, is the key thing for any enterprise application. And in 3.11 and in 3.1, we supported transaction recovery by storing the actual transactions and logging, making actual transaction logging in file systems. And file systems had their own issues. There were contention issues, and there was also a requirement on users to configure the NFS systems for distributed logging. So we fixed many issues in that area, and we have also, what we have done in 3.12 is we added support for storing transaction logging in database itself. So if you install 3.12, there'll be a pre-bundled database and pre-configured to take in your logging and store it in the database.
All right. So feature parity between admin console and CLI, DCOM, Eclipse link, top link, GMS with multicast or session failover with non-multicast environments, OSGI, and then I hear there are a whole bunch of other components that are updated as well.
Right. This is an usual exercise that we do for every release where we go through, we just feed through all the components that we bundle. And as you know, we bundle a lot of this implementations from other people or other companies and other community groups. And we also have our own set of libraries that we use to build GlassFish and run GlassFish. So as part of every release, we sweep through all these components to make sure that we carry the latest and greatest. And we did the exercise in 3.12, and we were able to update many of the components. I can name a few. The Weld implementation, that comes from JBoss got upgraded. We have an update to Hibernate Validator. We upgraded JSF. We upgraded JSP implementation. We upgraded Grizzly, and we went all the way to upgrade our HK2 layer also.
Excellent. Excellent. So now that contains, that kind of covers what the feature sets are coming in here.
Right.
Tell me about the list of supported configurations. You know, that was sort of our third theme for the release.
Right. As far as the operating systems are concerned, we have added support for macOS X 10.7.1 and Ubuntu 11.04 in 3.12. And for JDKs, we are officially supporting IBM JDK 6 starting this release. And we are also bundling the latest JDKs from Oracle, JDK 7 update 3 and JDK 6 update 31 along with our SDK releases. And on the client side, after we released 3.11, there were also releases of browsers that happened, like some releases of Internet Explorer, Firefox, Chrome came out. We have extended the support for our client side to include these browsers also.
All right. So better quality, new feature set,
right,
more supported configurations. Overall, that gives me a feeling, you know, Oracle is very much committed to GlassFish. So With 3.12 coming out in the next few hours, what do you think, you know, developers can expect next?
The fact that we are talking about 3.12 now, just a year after 3.1 got released, the fact that we have done two releases backed by Oracle itself reflects the commitment that Oracle provides on Glassfish community. And we also support our paying customers by providing them periodic patches and updates. And so you can expect more things from Glassfish product on this side. And we'll be working on Java E7, which is fast-oriented. And we'll be coming up with new versions of Glassfish as we go along. So at this time, stay tuned. We have a lot of activities happening here tuned towards Glassfish community.
Right. So what are the typical experiences for the Glassfish audience is NetBeans. How is NetBeans going to incorporate Glassfish 3.12 now?
So traditionally, we have bundled Glassfish releases with NetBeans, and we call them as NetBeans co-bundles. We are doing the same thing for 3.12 also. NetBeans 7.1.1 that is getting released, I believe, in a few hours, will have a bundle of Glassfish 3.12. So in addition to providing this co-bundle, this time we are also adding a few samples that are going to showcase some of the Glassfish functionality for NetBeans users.
Oh, nice. So Glassfish 3.12, as soon as it comes out, NetBeans users will have an ability, you know, it will have it co-bundled and it will be well integrated as it has always been.
Correct.
Very nice. So tell me about it. Now that 3.12 is getting released, what do my customers or my existing developers, deployers do if they are running either a 2.x, Glassfish 2.x or Glassfish 3.1x branches?
Okay. So if you are a 2.x customer, first of all, I would like to thank you for being a long-term customer with Glassfish. So if you want to move to 3.1.2, then your upgrade is going to be a two-step process. First step would be to upgrade your binaries. You can install 3.1.2 in a parallel directory that is in parallel to your existing 2.x install directory, and then run our AS upgrade tool, which is going to migrate your domain configuration and bring it up to speed with 3.1.2. And if you are an existing 3.1.x customer, it could be 3.1 or 3.1.1, then all you have to do is just do a binary upgrade. And you can do a binary upgrade in two ways. You can do it in place by using the update tool. The existing installation of 3.1 has an update tool. The moment 3.1.2 is released, the update tool would find out that there's a new update available and it will automatically prompt you for upgrade. Okay, that is an in-place upgrade. And you can also do a side-by-side upgrade by installing 3.1.2 on a different directory than the one that you where you have 3.1. And I should mention that for this scenario, from 3.1 or 3.1.1 to 3.1.2, there is no need to run your domain upgrade, because we have made sure that 3.1.2 is backward compatible with 3.1.1 and 3.1 in terms of domain configuration.
Very cool. Very cool. Excellent. So I think the developers have no reason to kind of hold back and literally just jump on the 3.1.2, either upgrade or, you know, just migrate, you know, and just get rolling with 3.1.2.
Right.
Excellent. Any last parting words?
3.1.2 is releasing in a few hours, as you said earlier. Please go try out 3.1.2, and we always value your feedback. Please download 3.1.2, try out. And if you have any questions, comments, we always appreciate your feedback.
And come back and connect to us at the Glassfish forums.
Right.
Thank you, Satyan, and I think it'll be a fun ride.
Thank you.